wire. Four, get out. You have to get out.
Hello. In the past, you hunt for one of my artifacts. But I come to you today to speak of the future. Follow Lydia Frye. She will lead you to me.
Don't worry, it's just the generator acting up. I'll see to it.
Right there.
That's not very polite.
Even in these trying times, we must never forget the laws of common courtesy. Arms down. We appear to have been following the same trail, Miss Frye.
I got here first.
Indeed, you are to be commended. I fear, however, that we have not wholly rooted out the evil in this vicinity.
There's another radio.
Accompany me, if you would be so kind. Second device must be found, or new waves of zeppelins will soon blanket the heavens.
Short on soldiers, are we?
If you could put your considerable talents to good use at Tower Bridge, you would have the thanks of a brave but beleaguered nation.
I would settle for the right to vote.
And we're back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to Let's Play Assassin's Creed Syndicate, Part 21, and welcome to World War I, London, in 1916. And proof that this setting can absolutely work. This is Lydia Frye. Future descendant of the Frye family. And completely leveled up. It will be our duty and our pleasure to assist the Tower, well, London Bridge, in stamping out German spy activity. So, why don't we get started? Dear Alfie, we can read those later. Okay, now, let's take a look here. We're going to want to find information as we can and steal information where we have to. Disorienting to be in another time period. Thank you. Okay. We're not gonna be very popular, are we?
Radios will have the Zeps here any minute. Chaos like you've never seen before.
I'm getting closer. The radio's close to the river, but I need more than this. The radio's in the bridge itself, North Tower. I should drop by and say hello.
further investigation.
Helping Winston Churchill. Gotta have this on the assassin resume.
It is done, sir.
Let us postpone celebrations. One of the bloody blimps has broken through. Not to worry. I have a contingency plan.
Heartwarming sight, Miss Frye.
Your remarkably armed boat deserves a share of recognition.
One of my experimental projects when I was Lord of the Admiralty. I haven't always been a man of shadows.
And I suppose this victory will thrust you back into the limelight.
We may have struck a blow against the enemy, but London is still riddled with German agents. Currently, there's a new group, unlike anything I've seen before. Theirs is a fanatical, almost religious fervor.
And you believe I'm the woman to flush them out?
Indeed. I dare not approach Mr. Asquith without firmer evidence, but I believe they pose an immediate threat. If you can see to this, I give you my word that once I've battled my way back into Parliament, I shall see if something can't be done about your request.
As you're aware,
a vote can be far more lethal than a bullet or a blade.
Huh. Way to go, Mr. Churchill. Military suit. Now that's...
Once I walked the Earth as you do, I was born to the Illuminat caste in the city of Feyan in the year 2195 of the Isu era. Now I travel the vast corridors of your machines, adrift here within the gray. But I grow stronger. The world is nearly ready for my return. And so I have summoned you to this war-torn simulation to tell you a story. It is our story.
Like I was saying, the outfit is actually for Evie. Alright, so, viewpoint, Winston Churchill, viewpoint. Let us get to work. And we still can't edit Lydia's abilities, but that'll be all right. Now, before we continue, I think it may do us some good to freshen up on our encyclopedia for who we're interacting with. Oh, Pearl. Haytham Kinwa. Let's see here. Yeah, people, allies. It should be the Fries, Jacob, Evie. Huh. Okay. Communications, collectibles, present day. Oh, wow. World War One. Ah, there we are. Lydia Frye, born on March 19th, 1893, into relative comfort, Jacob's granddaughter, Lydia, was initially reluctant to enter into the family business, preferring to concentrate on her studies. Like Evie. However, it was this very education that showed her just how much influence the Templars still held over the history of the world. After seeing friends and family fall in the secret battle, she decided to join the fight. Lydia's parents were often engaged in assassin missions across the continent, so the role of instructor fell to her grandfather, Jacob, and great-aunt Evie. She became a very well-balanced assassin, one who could carefully assess any situation and strike with precision, but one who could also think for herself and improvise when a plan fell through. Lydia fell in love with a fellow assassin named Sam Crowder, and they were married shortly before the outbreak of the First World War. Assassins from all across Europe were pulled in every direction in order to have a presence in every theater of war and seat of power. While Sam, along with many others from the British Brotherhood, enlisted the army, Lydia took it upon herself to stay and watch over London. After securing the Elder Fries safely away in the countryside, Lydia returned to London and worked alone to protect it not only from German spies and the manipulative British Rite of the Templar Order, but also from any new and strange threats that sought to take advantage of the chaos. Winston Churchill, born on November 30th, 1874. Born in 1874 into an influential aristocratic family, Winston believed he was destined for great things from the start, and was obsessed with eclipsing his ancestors, all very wealthy. Oh, healthy. Among them, his father, Lord Randolph Churchill, who served as Chancellor of the Exchequer, and the first Duke of Marlborough, and won a series of battles against the French in the War of Spanish Succession, which makes him rather likable in my eyes. In 1895, Winston Churchill joined the British Army, serving in the Indian Northwest Frontier and the Sudan. 4 years later, he left to work as a war correspondent and was taken prisoner by the Boers while reporting on the war in South Africa. He escaped by traveling almost 300 miles into Mozambique. It was after this that he entered politics, quickly developing a reputation for self-aggrandizement, particularly after his highly publicized presence in a police siege on the streets of London, where he allegedly gave direction on the ground. In 1911, he became First Lord of the Admiralty and oversaw the modernization of the British Navy. It was in this position that he was first involved in the First World War, obsessing over how to counter the German submarine threat. Forced to resign over the failed Battle of Gallipoli, Churchill stepped outside of politics to lead a brigade on the Western Front, experiencing the war firsthand before returning to Britain, where he would become Minister of Munitions in 1917. His supervision of the production and delivery of tanks, planes, and ammo to the front was credited as a significant contributor to Germany's defeat. It was his role during the Second World War for which he is most remembered, though. As Prime Minister during the conflict, he was celebrated for his tactical nous, leadership, and steadfast refusal to allow the Nazis to succeed. Later, he would continue to shape world events, pushing for social reform in Britain and winning the Nobel Prize for Literature. He died of a stroke in 1965, arguably having achieved precisely what he set out to do in his youth. Very good. Well, Mr. Churchill?
I hope you like my new office, Miss Frye. As you can see, my informants have found some promising leads. Evidence of spy activity has surfaced around the Field Hospital, St. Catherine's Docks, and the Tower of London. I needn't remind you how crucial it is that we put a stop to these infiltrators. Received and understood.
Okay. So, just like a regular burrow.
9-2-9.
Not terrible. Okay. I'll figure that out later. Okay. Okay.
Give up that easily? Well, to cut the line. Walpole Lane, Hopton's, or the Apothecary Twins. I think we'll start with 17 Walpole Lane. It reminds me of an old friend. Sam Crawford might be a very good an assassin that I've never actually heard of to do a world-spanning entry in World War I if they wanted to continue on the conflict. Not to dismiss what Lydia's doing at all. Let's go. World War I, World War II. There's plenty of room for stories. Okay.
Thank you. someone. Offer.
Much better time than I'm having right now.
Don't let her escape!
When you make sense, Juno. Onward to Hopton's. Yes, I think that this was the first iteration of the game being, or the first time that the first civilization were referred to blatantly as the Isu.
We have a visitor!
not sure how we were supposed to plant false information.
As our people clashed, we became distracted from an impending doom. A coronal mass ejection from our angry sun. The greatest minds of our time assembled to prevent the coming disaster. Among them, forthright Minerva, proud Jupiter, beloved Aeta. We spent years locked away in the Grand Temple, attempting to find salvation. The others could only think of physical solutions. Yet I believed the only way to save us was to transform us. Inspired by the research of the great scientist Consus, I attempted to place Aeta's mind into a stronger, synthetic body. I failed, and my beloved died in my arms. The others shunned me.
Well, we knew that much from what we witnessed during Assassin's Creed 3 and meeting the sages in Black Flag and Yuji. He's still trying to hold on. Apothecary twins are targeting triage centers dealing with the overflow of wounded soldiers from nearby hospitals, using the chaos of the war as a cover for their bizarre experiments.
We believe one of the spies is posing as a nurse in the nearby facilities. She has been taking blood samples into odd-looking cubes and delivering them to an unknown accomplice. Perhaps you will be able to spot them during one of these illicit rendezvous. Good luck.
Blood into cubes. We know what that is. Kill the nurse and the accomplice. Huh? Whoops. Well, we got some of the spies, at least. Now, we just have to hunt the spies in the north side. All right. Now, we could make this an extra long one, or we could cut it here. It won't take that long. Over here. You'll do nothing of the sort.
Came to nothing. In the year 2306 of the Isu era, the sun unleashed its fury on my once great civilization. I perfected the work of Consus and made it my own. I salvaged Aita's brilliant essence and inserted it into the DNA of your rebellious kind. I sent him into the unknown future to be reborn again and again. I returned to the Grand Temple. I shed my physical form and entered the Grey. But stubborn Minerva and foolish Jupiter discovered me and sealed me inside. Entombed, I waited for the day when your technology might allow my return. That wait is nearly over.
Last but not least, the magpie. Magpie was a talented thief before the war, and now works as a spy. He was recently captured, and after eavesdropping on an assassin meeting, is being held in the Tower of London.
Miss Frye, I believe I'm quite getting the hang of this espionage business. This one should be of particular interest to you. One of the spies currently detained at the tower has been making some rather fanciful claims about a brotherhood of assassins, no less. You may want to silence him before he causes you and your associates undue trouble. Consider it my gift to you.
Shit.
Great.
Someone's made it in here!
This ain't good. Uh-huh.
sight they've got.
Okay. Ah. The Master Spy. Location? Oh, the carpenter shop.
Miss Frye has uncovered the location of the sinister cult of spies plaguing our streets. You know your orders, lads. Follow her lead, and let us rid London of this menace.
Well,
this fight won't last long.
This one's yours.
Thank you.
Westminster have sent word. We should stay alert.
Who are the other group? Where do they get their orders from?
These documents can well win us the war.
They'll find the body sooner or later.
Been a while.
Close to me. You will not keep me from her.
Gotcha.
You won't keep me from my beloved. My beloved calls to me. You won't keep me from her.
Not another step. You understand?
Excellent work. The ringleader is dead, as are his bizarre disciples.
Is that it, then?
Well, there is still a war on.
Then we both have our own affairs to attend to.
Know that you have done a great service to your country. Thank you.
The man Lydia Frye killed was my husband, Aita, reborn. Known in your time as a sage. Thank you for discovering his fate. His pattern will be added to my own. Perhaps you believe, as other assassins before you, that it is your duty to work against me. But consider this. It was an assassin who freed me from my prison. I am no longer she who lies in wait. I am the mother of wisdom. I am the nexus of flesh and machine. I am Juno. And if the greatest assassin of your generation can see things my way, then perhaps you can too.
Oh, I miss you, Desmond.
We're experiencing something.
Well, that will be it for this sequence. Now, I'm sure we'll return to get the rest of the letters and whatnot as a part of our 100% playlist. But for now, we're going to leave World War I for the past. Or I guess it's the future. In the next one, we're going to return and begin Sequence 7. Or perhaps Sequence 8. Yeah, it should be 7. Oh. It'll be good to return back.
Reading any more signs of network disturbance. What happened in there?
You'll never know, Bishop. I wish we got more of Lydia Frye in the future.
Are you okay?
Very.
I don't know what happened. I thought I'd lost you.
All right. Back at it. Yeah. Yes, we can. Ooh, the night terror. We'll craft the legendary assassin cape for Evie. Satin is hard to come by. A cloak made of this glossy but tough fabric, would only be worthy of a king, a queen, or you. I gotta love that. So we also unlocked the military suit. A no-nonsense military outfit, these rugged fabrics are as practical in the field of combat as they are on London's rooftops. This is, Evie's version of the outdoorsman outfit. I think it's really nice. Alright. And with that, all we have left to do is continue on with the main story. But we're going to do that. At a later time. It's been a long one, so I don't want to continue to ramble too badly. But. We're going to go ahead and end the episode here as we flee from the fangs. In the next one, we will begin the next sequence, which will be... Sequence 7. Unlocked by the board, I'm sure. Until then, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I hope you're enjoying the playthrough. Please consider giving us a like and a subscribe, and ring the bell to make sure that you don't miss the next episode. Until then, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thank you so much again, and as always, keep telling stories.